Thank you, Jean-François. Welcome, everyone. So I'm very happy to be here with you. And we have, we are also very honored to have with us Pierre Dichouliot. So I can introduce Pierre, maybe, right now. It's okay. Wow. So, Pierre, you were born in Paris in 1961, and at 20 years old, you published Qui résiste, an experimental publication which investigates typography as a medium through writing and drawing. In 1995, you designed Amanar, an amazing typeface for Touareg and their traditional writing system. You worked on such projects at the Centre National de la Danse in Pantin, the facade of the Champollion Museum, the Forum des Images in Paris, the Anagrams Generator in Brest, etc. So Pierre, you are a lettering artist, public writer, and graphic designer. And you like to play with the language of everyday life. We're delighted to have you with us today, so please welcome Pierre Dichouliot.
Thank you very much. Bon, la salle est chauffée comme si c'était un cabaret. First of all, please, I apologize for my very strange English. It would be very difficult for people speaking both the two languages, French and English. But us, it's very rare. C'est très très rare de rencontrer des gens qui maîtrisent les deux langues, surtout à Paris. I hope for you, vous êtes soit des très bons francophones, soit des très bons anglophones. Ok. Perfect. Thank you very much, Jean-François. Well, as I know, I am in Type Paris. I went into my archives and I found this very old school cahier, school book. It's my my apprentissage, my learning of writing when I was 5 years old, between 5 and 6. So you can appreciate the logotype of the town of Paris here. And you will see why I want to show it to you. Immediately, I was very strongly encouraged by the teacher. Mediocre. English, very bad. It's very physical. Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire, ça? J'ai appuyé sur rien.
Style médiocre. What do you want? Restart?
No.
Stop?
Yes. Et pourquoi ça fait ça? Bon, on ne sait pas. Donc, les chiffres, c'est un peu mieux. Un ballon, one dog, one boat, one duck, one. It's why I cannot believe to the neutrality of sign. Ouais, more or less good. Ni 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 ni. Médiocre. It's also a document about the art of teaching. Médiocre. Day by day, I was encouraged by this teacher. Médiocre, nah. Pourtant, it's very nice, my nah. Na 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 na. It's a girl in French slang. You can well, something strange happened here. Free cherries. Donc conduite neuf. Conduite, je ne sais pas le traduire. Quelqu'un peut me dire conduite en anglais, comment on dit? Behavior. C'est pas le fait d'être heureux, ça? Bon, enfin, behavior. Nine. Work seven. And the same nature of my father. If you can read it, it was a dictée. Aline a un loto. Worth on worth, passable. It's even more deep than mediocre. Mediocre is very bad, but passable it's worth. The teacher has not hope anymore about my talent to writing. Copy. Papa a ôté l'épine. Et papa a une pipe. Et là, on n'arrive pas. Oui, it's impossible to read. Le vélo va vite. And the conclusion is terrible. Can you read? This child is quite intelligent, but really, he will never write correctly anymore. And it's the truth. I suppose I don't have to comment anymore. I jumped to a realization quite fresh, because it was opening in the year 2014. Je ne sais même pas dire 2014 en anglais, vous voyez le niveau. 2013. Wow, c'est la première fois de ma vie que j'arrive à dire 2000. So it's a memorial Notre-Dame de Lorette, Albin Saint-Nazaire. So, what was the subject? It's a commission of the country Nord-Pas-de-Calais in the north of France. They wanted to honorate all the soldiers of all the nations, all the men who were dead on the ground of this country between 1914 and 1918. Parce que je peux dire 2000, mais pas 1000. 1290, etc. 1914-1918. So they asked to us, because we were a team, we win a competition, a pitch. Tu sais que ça me fait beaucoup de bien, Véronique, quand tu fais oui à chaque fois que je dis fais pas une faute d'anglais. So the architect is Philippe Prost. And the question was to engrave 600 Toussaint's names of soldiers. Là, c'est bon en plus. And with absolutely a strict alphabetical order, no preference, no indication about the nationality of each soldier, neither a word about in which army he was. So the problem is that you need a lot of space to propose to the audience to read correctly the name of the soldiers and also to be in the good mood. Alors ça, vraiment, je peux pas dire en anglais, pour être dans une ambiance de recueillement. So my work was to construct the design on the typographic level on this work. And I've designed a typeface. If this is the first sketch of this typeface, the first tape, not the first sketch, but the first tape. The name is Lorette, because it's the name of the cemetery in front of the memorial. So c'est le lorette number one. After that, you have the lorette number two. Its border, it's thinner. And the lorette number three. As you see, it's really, ça prend beaucoup moins de place, ça chasse beaucoup moins. And this character need to be adapted to the technique of engraving. I can say a lot of the technique, not because of my horrible English, but because I have signed a paper what I cannot say not too much about it. J'ai signé un papier comme quoi j'ai pas le droit d'en parler. Parce que c'est secret, il y a un brevet sur cette technique. Mais c'est gravé. So you can touch the name of the dead soldiers. And comme je sais que c'est une assemblée de fins typographes, I suppose that you would like very much to see the letters very big on the screen. So it allows you to see a lot of choice. Je vais assez vite, I'm going quicker. But you can see that the choice is sometimes to exaggerate. La typo, de toute façon, c'est tout le temps exagéré. Il faut exagérer tout le temps, tout le temps, tout le temps. Et j'aime beaucoup exagérer, donc ça tombe bien. Quoi? In English, exaggerate? I'm not obliged to speak French, okay. I will stay in English. This letter, for example, the letter Q, it's a choice first to be very economic with the space. So it's la clé du, pardon, excuse me. The Q of the Q, non, la queue du Q, comment on dit ça en anglais? Tu vois, c'est horrible. Je peux pas rester à l'anglais simplement. C'est quoi?
Tale of the queue.
Ah, the tale of the queue. Mais the tale, ça veut dire c'est une histoire, tale? Fairy tale? Ah, tal. D'accord. I'm sorry. So it's the Egyptian way. You know, of course, you know that this letter came from the stylization of the human face directly from the Egyptian. Là, il manque plus que les deux petits points et on a le signe de skin hoche. For the readers of Tintin. What to say? Where are you? Each letter is very not independent, but very comment dire caractérisé. C'est bête de dire ça d'un caractère. Un caractère caractérisé. Chaque lettre. The autonomy of each letter is pushed on. And it's a little bit stupid to be proud of some letters, but I'm very proud of this W. W first, I like very much the word W, U. But also because, enfin voilà quoi, ça me plaît. And now we are going to the place directly. The photography were made by Heitor Ortiz, a Spanish photographer. So what is very special, you know, here, it's a very, very huge, it's the biggest military French graveyard. You have 24 tombstones. Tombs here, and here you have the names of these 600 tombs. Exactement, il y en a 579,606. This is an help memory. This is the characteristic of the béton. Comment on dit béton en anglais? Concrete. Thank you. concrete. It's a concrete pré-contraint, mais post-tendu. Don't ask me what is it exactly, mais c'est vachement joli. Il est comment ton béton? Il est pré-contraint, mais post-tendu. Je pense qu'en anglais, c'est pareil. Et c'est ça qui permet, c'est parce qu'il est pré-contraint et post-tendu, it's why it's so elegant and so light. To express the fragility of the piece, the architect made the choice to construct a very thin ring and put on the wall on us with you have a declinity. You have a part of the ring which is on the empty space. When you see this, it means that it's the end of a series of panels with one letter. For example, the letter G. You have the first panel with the letter G, the last one. The names of the soldiers are not going at the bottom of the panel. You can see this incredible space. When you see the shadow, you see very well the fragility of the piece. And this is the zoom about one panel. So my purpose when I did the design, it's first to allow each everybody to find the name of an ancestor in 5 or 10 minutes. It's not because you have a rush, but because if you want to read everything, it will take 1 month and a half reading all the names. I need to close this document to open another one. Donc j'ouvre le document numéro 2. So it's the following. Donc 579 and 606 name of soldiers. First of all, it's absolutely crazy. Can you imagine it? In 4 years, these men, these young men, came in from everywhere. 294,000 soldiers from the Britannic Empire. 154,000 Germans. 110,000 French. And 8,000 other nationality. If we use our notion of nationality of today, we have 42 different nationality on this monument. If we are in the notion of nationality of of the First War, you have only 10 nationalities à cause des colonies. So look, it's more or less the dimension, the surface of the field. I mean, if you take the names and you put it on a 1 meter hole, and you're doing like this, le terrain était complètement rempli. It's why it was so important to be very economic with the space. It's also the name of the number of letters, it's like 10 times the Vietnam Veterans Memorial, which is a very famous and a very big memorial. It will be a text. It will be like 23 books of 200 pages. If you use a normal typeface, for example, my typeface Gararon, I try it first. It will take 200 and 500 meters squares of engraved surface. Bon, ça c'est je ne sais plus pourquoi je montre cet exemple. Oui, parce que, of course, it's because we are in this situation because our system of reading is from left to right. This is to say that, as we are outside, of course, when you engrave a letter outside, it's the shadow, the light. And the natural light is always vertical, so you have to exaggerate. Not the horizontal lines, because you will always have a shadow on the horizontal lines, but you have to exaggerate the oblique and the vertical. The first sketch, in fact, here you have a more or less all the project of the typeface. If you remember the first slides I showed about my book when I was a child, you can see that I'm still a very bad drawer of letters. This is a research about something, quelque chose que j'ai abandonné. Comment est-ce qu'on dit ça, quelque chose que j'ai abandonné? I give up with this. My point was to do a lot of ligatures in other languages, exactement comme Madame Infini a fait. Elle n'est pas là par rapport à Sandrine. You see what I mean when I'm talking about infinite typeface? Okay. But I was obliged to give up with it because the historian in charge of the... Oh, qu'est-ce que j'ai fait? Hop, oh là là là, hop. Because the historian tell me what I cannot... It's impossible that with my typeface I make a difference between the soldiers. Every man have to be on the same level of legibility. As I am not, it's impossible to do a typeface taking care of each name. I mean, if sometimes I have a name with the ligature ELL, bon, enfin voilà, c'est impossible, quoi. Peut-être avancer. Ça, c'est des calculs, calculations very number of names, number of letters by names, to have exactly l'importance du nombre de signes sur le total. T1, T2. 10 millions de lettres, 10 679 650, avec ce calcul. Tout ça a l'air très savant, mais en fait, c'était tout faux. Comment dire? Enfin, je ne peux pas vous expliquer pourquoi c'était faux, c'était quand même pas mal. Mais quand on a... When we received the real, real good list, it was very biggest than previous. Parce que la réalité est toujours plus forte que la fiction, n'est-ce pas? The Lorette version 1. With the version 2, I win 16% of space. Et là, 27% with the free one. Do you want me to comment red circles? Yes. Well, it's a subterfuge. If you want to look at a professional type designer, you have to do some red circle on your letters. No, it's a joke. It's a joke. In fact, il y a vraiment quelque chose qui se passe ici. What's happening? Ça, c'est ce qu'on appelle un piège à encre. Ink trap in English, thank you. But why? Because you don't have any ink in this project. Yet it's true, but I like so much ink trap. No, it's not the truth. It's because it's when you design the letter, you have this very, very huge on your screen, very big, but after that, it's engraved at a very small size. So you have to exaggerate everything and also the white into the angles, if you want to be sure that at the end, it's again an angle, it's not anymore a curve. So it's useful also if you don't use ink. Est-ce que les francophones ont compris quelque chose à ce que je viens de dire? Ça, c'est incroyable. Il y a des gens qui disent oui. Parce que moi, je ne comprends pas ce que je raconte. Here, it's because you must observe that the P is very different from the R. And here, je ne sais pas pourquoi j'ai fait ça. Là. Ah, si, je sais. Yes. My first impression was a typeface for les bottins téléphoniques. Comment on dit ça en anglais? The what? Address book, thank you very much. Phone books. Address books. And I will not say the name of the designer because I don't like at all his work. But... Monsieur qui a dessiné le Verdana, comment il s'appelle déjà?
It's not live screen, so
you can change the name. Non, mais justement, comment s'appelle-t-il déjà? J'ai un trou de mémoire.
It's a guy with a ponytail.
Oui, mais comment il s'appelle?
Yeah,
comme le cul?
Non, I would not say that. It's a type designer with a ponytail.
Non, mais attends, il mérite tout notre plus grand respect. Quel est son nom? Rappelle-moi. Yes, Matthew Carter. Excuse me. Since in the first level, I have a huge respect for him. I remember I was at a lecture of him in the Pompidou Center 3 years ago, maybe. It was very interesting because his lecture was very good, but I am in disagreement with all the lecture from the first one to the last one. But I was very impressed about his belle centennial. C'est bien lui qui l'a dessiné. Bon, j'ai eu chaud. I go on. Here, I tried to apply an advice of Adrien Frutiger when he was working about OCR-B. It's what, if you want a good legibility of letters, you have to amplify the difference between letters, which are very closed. C'est ça le sens du BR, BD, BP, BP. Ça, c'est ce que... It's this part of the work I stopped after a moment, but it was my inspiration. It's in the church in Italy, in Siena. This is only a research to find the good separator point, separator dot, between the words. In fact, I use no one of only a simple circle, but I have more white after than before. Using this white space, it's very important because you immediately recognize the beginning, this little space. Vous fait comprendre que là commence le nom du prochain soldat. Here begins the word of the next soldier. This is a try. If it's not engraved, but if it's a numeric phrase, c'est pas strawberry, une phrase numérique. Une phrase numérique. Drill. Drill. Pour moi, c'est un singe, un drill, un mandrill. Thank you very much. A numeric drill. So it's very ugly. It's to prove that it don't work. In this typeface, I made all the cunning pairs. Very old, because you cannot imagine that the invention of some people, some country, into the combination of letters for some name of men. Par exemple, en tchèque, en polonais, il y a des ressources inépuisables. So when you have a panel, the first panel of a letter beginning with a latrine, and after that, if you count 30 lines, all the 30 lines, you have the three first letters of the first name dans la gouttière. So it's like in a dictionary. And here you can observe the incredible irregularity of the number of names of soldiers depending on the first letter of their name. It's why my very savant calcul was not exact at the beginning on the sketchbook. I showed you before. Parce que je n'ai pas assez tenu compte du fait que les noms, par exemple, commençant par la lettre M, sont beaucoup plus longs que les noms qui commencent par la lettre E. Pourquoi il y aurait de quoi faire toute une conférence. Mais le fait est là. I will not translate this. This is a very important document. It's the guide of how to to carry the panels on the le chantier. How to la pose et le transport et la pose des panneaux et leur pose dans le bon ordre. How to do it in the good order, because when you have all these panels beginning with the letter A, it's very difficult when you are here to be not confused between the number 8 and number 9. So it's a guide for the men working on the building. This is a prototype on the left. So the first two panels to see if everything is correct. After that, we can go on the production to produce everything. And this is a mix of all the really terrible things I received as a try of different producers and gravers. They proposed me this thing, for example. I had a heart attack. C'est vraiment... Oh bon. Par charité, je tairai le nom de ces fournisseurs. Et c'est ça que nous avons choisi. It's an engraving very, very light. It's very lightly under the level of the surface. C'est de l'acier inoxydable, inoxydable. C'est ça. Iron. But colored. Colorated. Et she was my assistant at this moment, Diane Boivin. Et donc, ce n'est pas une scène pour Nosferatu. It's a try of light and enlightenment by night. With different type of lights. Ça, on l'a déjà vu. How many times do I have again? Pardon? Encore 30 minutes? Génial. It's okay, are you okay?
Yes.
Bon, super. On va changer de genre. We change of mood. With another work I did very recently. Non, je dois revenir là. J'ouvre le dossier numéro 01 à nouveau. Et après, je vais en sortir et je vais revenir. Ça va être terrible. What do you say? I'm listening very carefully and I'm not sure I understand you very well. C'est bizarre parce que je n'avais pas compris que je devais faire la conférence en anglais, j'avais déjà mis ça dans la projection. Two years ago, I was at a meal for a birthday of a friend of mine, Frédéric. And in front of the restaurant, you have a garage. Garage. It's a place where you put your cars. And walking to take some brief, I was stupefied by the beauty of this word and these four letters. Et toi? Donc je quitte le fichier numéro 1 et je reviens au numéro 2. C'est de la complexité low-tech. Donc j'ai dessiné ce caractère, le carrelage. Trying to avoid, I have designed this typeface, the carrelage, trying to avoid the effect maillot pour une université américaine. How to say this?
College jersey. College jersey.
Turkey?
Jersey. Jersey.
Yes, I try to avoid the effect of college jersey. Thank you very much. And ça, c'est ce qu'on appelle un, comment dire, un spécimen. J'aime bien cette phrase-là. It's incredible, it's very legible because I work a lot about the canning. J'ai encore un fait pour le W. I am still in love with W. Malheureusement, il n'y a pas beaucoup de mots français avec W. W is not very frequent in French language. But in English, wow. Alors, I have a renaissance commission, it's to a fromagerie. Comment ça se dit, fromagerie? Ça se dit comme ça avec l'accent pour. A cheese shop? Non, mais c'est incroyable, j'apprends des mots absolument extraordinaires ce soir. A cheese shop. So, a man, il s'appelle Sébastien Drick. He was a journalist at the newspaper Libération. Pardon, Libération. Ça se dit pas en anglais comme ça. In French is the text, Libération. But he preferred now to sell cheese than to be anymore in Libération. Il m'a demandé de faire une enseigne et je lui ai proposé. I say, yes, I'm very happy to do it. I will use my character Carrelage. In fact, it was not correct at all. It was illegible. Most of all, because I have all the scanning pairs, it was impossible to write the nice lines of Carrelage between the letters. I mean, everything that is around the character. Ah oui, tu veux faire pommage? Merci. Je ne sais pas si c'est clair en français même ce que je viens de vous dire. Le problème, c'est comme j'avais beaucoup travaillé les paires d'approches, si je voulais combler l'espace entre les lettres avec des lignes de carrelage et que le carreleur ne devienne pas fou, j'ai oublié de dire ça. Parce qu'avec un carreleur fou, ça aurait peut-être été possible, mais le carreleur ne voulait pas du tout devenir fou. Donc il ne voulait pas avoir des lignes avec des quarts de carreaux, des huitièmes de carreaux, des carreaux pleins, des carreaux aux deux tiers, des carreaux aux trois quarts, et ainsi de suite, jusqu'à folie complète et irrémédiable. So, how's my caroler? Personne ne me reprend, donc ça doit être ça. Donc, this is my case charge. I will try this system every time. My case charge. I don't want my caroler to become mad, so I ask him only to use the carreau, the square, complete, or half in diagonal, on half straight, en biseau 26 degrés de l'angle jusqu'à la médiane. En biseau 45 degrés, là déjà, he become to have a headache. Et un quart droit, ça c'est facile parce que ça c'est la moitié de ça, si vous suivez. Puis même j'ai fait un petit dessin pour qu'ils comprennent sur la carrelette. The cutting machine for the carreau. I use too much colors, I have to be more calm after that with the colors because it was too expensive for only one signage. So I have redesigned all the letters, especially for the signage, more tall. So my caroler is not mad, he's in good health. You have a range of squares each time, nice. Pas de demi-carreau, pas de truc, enfin voilà, tout est... C'est standardisé, quoi. Oui, c'est au carreau. Fromagerie La Pantinoise. So it's a very nice name because it will be in the town of Pantin near Paris. But it's the only one. Cheese shop. Cheese shop. Cheese shop. Simulation sur existant. It was my first try in color, but I was not happy with it because too much color only to have like an effect of... un effet d'enfermement du caractère. Sans jeu de mots avec la folie. Enfin, c'était pas bien, quoi. It was not very... I don't like it at all. After, I was very happy with one day with it. During one day. And this is, it was a nice proposal about the way of... put the squares into the windows, but it was not possible because windows is always closed. Donc on voit pas le tableau de la fenêtre. Donc je ferme ce document et je rouvre le document 05. C'est un document de travail. It's a document of work, working progress document. It's why you have this very ugly slide, but it's only to have the good number of the reference on the catalogue of Caro. Tile. Tyler, c'est un catalogue ou c'est un carreau?
Tyler, c'est
Tyler, c'est le carreleur. Ah oui, d'accord. Merci beaucoup. Et le catalogue des carreaux, on va dire comment? The Tile catalogue. C'est comme ça que ça marche, en fait, avec l'anglais. Tu colles les trucs ensemble et ça marche. The Tile catalogue for the cheese shopper. Je sens que j'ai fait quelque chose pas bien. Bon, is it clear this project for you? Yes. So, do I have 5 minutes again to show the last project? Do you want to ask your question now, or do you allow me? Or do you want another project?
Yes.
Okay. Alors, je vais vous montrer quelque chose de très facile à traduire, c'est le composteur d'adresses prédictives. Déjà, en français, c'est incompréhensible. Bonjour en anglais. Ouais, je vais essayer. Je me lance. Your next address will be predicted by this strange tool very quickly and efficiently. Voilà, ça c'est une traduction. En plus, je montre autre chose pour commencer, c'est pas grave. And if it's the pleasure of your eyes, it's another typeface. I show it to you very quickly. Ça s'appelle les mots flottés, the floating words. The principle of this type is when you have only the first line up, if you have the upper line and not the line under the upper, what is the celle du haut, mais quand tu montes, celle du bas, upper. The upper line, c'est la ligne du dessus, mais la ligne du dessous.
Lower,
thank you. When you have only the upper line, normally you cannot read. And when you have also the underline, non, il va falloir la ligne en dessous, quoi. Quand vous avez le dessous du dessus, ce qui reflète le dessus du dessous, normalement ça marche. Can you read?
Yes.
Thank you very much. It's all these sentences are approximation of meditation en pleine conscience. It's to help the people very lost in the head. Tous les gens qui semblent perdus au rayon bien-être de la FNAC. Méditation en pleine conscience. Full conscience meditation. Here it's more full panade meditation. So reflection in very mediocre. On retrouve médiocre. Vous voyez que j'étais traumatisé. Médiocre. Penser en apnée du vouloir. C'est bizarre, personne ne traduit. Hallucination, petite idée. Pense à moi, je suis à toi. Think to me, I belong to you. J'y suis, j'y pense. I am here, I'm thinking. Je pense à ça, donc j'hésite. Toute référence est totalement volontaire. Analyser sans y penser, c'est ce qu'on fait la plupart du temps. Et gamberge à tous les étages. Comment on dit gamberge en anglais? Nana. What? Wonder. It's a kind of wondering, very special. La gamberging, c'est... The wondering. Thank you. It was made for a friend of my marvelous artist, Catherine Contour, qui est chorégraphe, et c'est fait à Royaumont dans le cadre d'une promenade hypnotique qu'elle appelle des plages. Et ça, c'est d'autres anciens travaux de référence que j'ai mis là pour qu'on comprenne que j'adore les axes de symétrie. I do like symmetry, mirror, inversion, etc. Et voilà le compositeur d'adresse prédictive, donc la partie la plus intraduisible de tout mon exposé. Alors, the point was I was invited by a curator in an exhibition about the artist in the town. On my vision of the town in this work, that it's very difficult to know where you are going to move, and what will be the name of your the next street where you will be, où tu vas emménager. Comment tu vas connaître le nom de la rue? Alors, this is a magic tool to know this name, to know your next address. So everything is moving. Ça va tourner. It will be built in my next exhibition au Bel Ordinaire, un centre d'art, a center of art in the south of France, in the very wonderful town of Pau. It's also a reminiscence of my first sketch. Pa, 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 you remember? Donc là, c'est Pau. So how it work? This is a prototype. And the name of this thing you cannot see very clearly. C'est pas un roulement à billes, c'est un palier auto-aligneur. Et ça, vraiment, je ne le traduirai pas. Il faut être fort en mécanique, c'est tout. Capacité de rotation, 3000 tours minute. Je pense que 2000 tours dans l'année suffiront. This sketch. Arrêtez, ça me déconcentre. Ce dessin, c'est pour le le système d'indexation ou d'indexage. On a les deux mots en français. Indexation. The question is, I want what where you when you will look to your next address and manipulate my compositor d'adresse prédictive. I want all the faces of the volumes are aligned. In a range. Comment tu dirais ça, Eric? Online. Lines. Thank you. So it's very difficult. I will not explain to you how I will do it. But you have to be concentrated. You have all the projects here. Donc you have first the action. You have six choices. I'm leaving. Come on quickly, I'm leaving, je m'en vais. Rendez-vous, let's go to, j'arrive. Il faut pas, I have to move from, là il y a 99 chiffres, là il y a the name of the street, not the name, le nom de la voie. And here you have all the possibilities. Donc ça fait 116 millions 5 non enfin bref 116 785 652 possibilités d'adresses dont 32 768 substantifs. Vraiment vous ne croyez pas, alors je vous donne une preuve. On peut par exemple aller habiter à la Basitude, à la Bazounette, à la Giclouille, à la Giclocyonite, à la Gicherque, à la Pourchoisse, à la Lugnorine, à la Solélome, à la Crassionite. À la Lusitrice, on peut aller passage de la Désirologue, qui est un endroit que j'aime beaucoup. Mais si on a rencontré Sarkozy la veille, on peut aller à la Carcheresse, hélas. Si on a entendu parler de Carla Bruni, il y a la Carlationite ici. À moins qu'on aille à la Louclouille, qui est un endroit qu'elle fréquente très souvent. Moi, je préfère la Louloute. Quand elle est seule, c'est la Seuloute. La Fébéritude. Alors évidemment, je vais vous traduire tout ça maintenant. Non, bah écoutez, je pense que c'est bien de s'arrêter là. Je vous remercie beaucoup de votre attention et je vais vous répondre à vos questions maintenant.
Wow. Karcherg. Pour Sarkozy.
Karcheresse pour Sarkozy. Karcherg, ça sonne un peu du sud et justement c'était pour Toulon au départ.
Ok.
Mais Carvenut, it's not the name of d'une tribu gauloise.
Carvenut.
Il y a la forêt des Carnutes, mais Carvenut, c'est pas le nom d'une tribu gauloise, je précise.
So thank you so much. It's time for questions. So, does anybody have any question for Pierre?
In both English and French language.
Like in French, know. In English, in German.
Ou en Moldo-Slovaque.
Yes, there is a question here.
Ah, oui, d'accord. Si je me souviens d'où c'est, je crois que c'est là. Ah oui, mais dehors, j'ai pas montré toutes les images en fait. Il y a des gens qui sont très attentifs. Hein. Ah, c'est là. Ah oui, parce que moi je voulais vous montrer un petit. J'ai oublié deux images. Ça vous embête pas avant de répondre à votre question? Pourquoi j'ai voulu montrer ça? Oh yes. With the help of a very nice young woman in the audience, I am proud to say that je déménage du chapeau, je ne sais même plus où j'habite, je marche à côté de mes pompes. Il est à la rue, il est complètement à l'ouest. Lui, on l'a perdu, ça fait même longtemps. Tout ça, ça se dit en anglais. I am going out of my mind. Mais pourquoi je dis ça? C'est la réponse doit être l'image suivante. Oh yes, it's my definition of graphic design, on type design. On voit le type design et c'est surtout en bas, at the end of the. I have some principles that are very well arranged in a small about typograph.
Another question?
But
this is. Do you have a question? No? Yes? Yes, there are questions here.
Le composteur.
Le truc qui roule.
Non, c'est mon initiative. Alors, le bel ordinaire, parce qu'ils ont eu la gentillesse de m'inviter. Enfin, ils se sont adressés à Francesca Cozzolino, qui est anthropologue, qui enseigne aux Arts Déco à Paris, entre autres, qui a été enseignée à Pau avant, qui explique que Florence de Meckenem, qui dirige le bel ordinaire, lui a dit « Qui est-ce qu'on pourra bien inviter ?» Francesca a dit « Oh, ben, j'aimerais bien inviter Pierre Dissiulo. » Et Florence lui a dit « Ah, justement, j'avais envie de l'inviter. » Voilà, ils m'ont invité et j'ai proposé le composteur d'adresse prédictive.
So in English, the composter is your idea or
yes. The composter is one of my projects. And what is a composter in French in English? A composter is some if everybody think about a machine to pour percer un trou pour compost to make all the two papers. In fact, in French, it's something else before. A composter, it's a tu voudrais pas le dire?
Composing stick.
Composite stick. Donc c'était fait pour composer avant d'être fait pour composter. Composing stick, is it clear for you? C'est quand on est de l'ouvrier typographe, the typographe workers is instead of the casting. Il vaut mieux que j'arrête ce massacre. Enfin c'est voilà, le composteur sert à composer. C'est pour ça que quand vous tournez les faces, when you manipulated, you construct a new line of text. Est-ce que j'ai répondu à votre question?
Yes. We have one question here, Jean-François.
If you have an advice to a young designer who want to learn type design, what you have to avoid to do? Si tu dois donner un conseil à un jeune designer qui veut démarrer la création de caractères, qu'est-ce qu'il ne doit pas faire?
Écoutez les conseils.
I need to translate in English. You don't have to follow the
advices.
The advices, yeah, exactly. It's the best advice. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Pierre.
Thank you very much for the invitation.
So, what's next?
Thank you, Pierre.